lessons, we cannot forget history. That is what he said. That is what Abraham Lincoln said. This Congress and this administration will be remembered in spite of itself. No personal significance or insignificance can excuse one or the other of us. The fiery trial through which we pass will light us down in honor or dishonor. We here have the power and bear the responsibility. Born in Kentucky, raised in Indiana, he lived in Illinois. And this is what he said. This is what Abraham Lincoln said. The dogmas of the quiet past are inadequate to the stormy present. Our occasion is piled high with difficulty, and we must rise to the occasion. As our case is new, so we must think anew and act anew. We must disenthrall ourselves, and then we will save our country. When standing erect, he stood 6'4" tall, and this is what he said. He said, it is the eternal struggle between two principles, right and wrong, throughout the world. It matters not in what shape it comes, whether from the mouth of a king who seeks to bestride the people of his own nation of the fruits of their own labor, or as an apology of one race of men to enslave another race. It is the same tyrannical principle. Abraham Lincoln was a quiet man. He was a quiet and a melancholy man. But when he spoke of democracy, this is what he said. He said, as I would not be a slave, so I will not be a master. This expresses my idea of democracy. Whatever differs from this, to the extent of that difference, is no democracy. Thank you. Abraham Lincoln, 16th president of these United States, is everlasting in the memory of his countrymen. For at the battleground at Gettysburg, this is what he said, that from these honored dead, we take increased devotion to that which they gave their last full measure of devotion, that we here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain, and that our nation shall have a new birth under God of freedom, and that government of the people, by the people, and for the people shall not perish from this earth. Ladies and gentlemen, those were the stirring and immortal words of Abraham Lincoln, our 16th president. I have received during the course of this weekend a message from the fulfillment of those words, a message from the office of the President of the United States, who is indeed for us, and we believe for the world, that audacious fulfillment of hope that said, yes, we can, and did. The President's message is long and thoughtful, but in particular, I wish to highlight the following words. President Obama, our 44th President, writes to us that as you celebrate in Malta, it is not just America's celebration. It is instead a celebration of our common humanity. This is, of course, the same realization that President Abela and I had just the other morning about the common ground upon which our nations stand. And President Obama concludes that he is particularly delighted that we can mark this birthday together as diplomatic friends. And I too am particularly pleased that we are together as friends. And for that reason, I would like to toast the friendship of Malta and the United States, and to our continued cooperation in meeting global challenges, and to the health and well-being of the President and the people of the Republic of Malta. But you know, there's only one proper way in which this can be done. Because you were a people of great spirit and great character even before 1964 and your declaration. And one of the ways in which you express that is in a marvelous language. So if you'll permit me. You issa nishtek li nerfau etasi. Unish orbu besaha talha biberia main Malta u listate uniti. Eia nagaro il incamplu ni cooperos sabish nilhal al is fidi globali. Nagaro saha yuhena il president u il pueblo ta Malta. Ugiri. Ugiri.